Hey everyone, this is AVJV Gaming for you guys. Episode number 3, or team of the season number 3, which is our British Premier League players. And as you can see, we got a lot of familiar faces up on screen. In this episode, guys, I'll be talking about some of their stats in comparison to the base cards, which are their just the normal default cards, and also some about some of the in-game stats, because I've heard some of them have some really crazy in-game stats. And yeah, so we'll start off, guys. We'll start with our strikers up front. We have Luis Suarez and Van Persie, and those two together are very great. We're going to go through some of the stats now with Suarez. As you can see, he's got 88 pace, very useful, and also he's got 94 shooting. And that 94 shooting, guys, is a increase in 11 from his normal default base card, so that is very, very strong. Another stat which is very strong in him is his 84 passing, which is an increase in 10, which is vital for having a good player up front who can pass the ball effectively and also get the ball and then finish it off. And his shooting is incredible, so we're gonna have to see how he fares out. I've been told a lot of players are really, really good with their aerial threat as well with some of these players. So as you can see, his headering as well has gone up to 80, so that's another increase in 10 over there. So from 70 to 80, a very, very nice stat increase. So it's going to be kind of interesting to see how he does fare out in the game. I'd like to see, definitely, maybe I want to come up against any opponents. So if you guys have opened any of these guys in packs, let me know if you're one of my subscribers, or let me know if I want to play some of these players, unless I'm going to have to buy them and have to try them out myself. Our next player up on the front is Robin Van Persie, or RVP. Had an absolutely crazy season this year at United, and as you can see, some of his stats just look crazy in themselves. Shooting gone up to 96. His default one is, I think, 89, so that's a nice increase in 7 over there. His pace has also gone up to 84, which is nice to have, because normally he was quite slow with 70, I think it was around 70 something pace. So yeah, his pace has now gone up to 84, and that's in the mid-80s, and that's going to be quite interesting. Dribbling as well, 91. Going to be able to keep control of the ball right at his feet and not be able to, like, lose control of the ball. And had experiences with him where he just sometimes just loses the ball just because of bad touch. And hopefully that's going to be great about this team this season player. So we're going to move now into the midfield. So we've got Bale, we've got Mata, we have Carrick, and we have Hazard. And as you can see, guys, Hazard over there in the right mid has actually changed positions, so he's going to be even probably worth more to people, as he's going to be on the right hand side, and you can have some alternatives to the left hand side, so you can make a very, very strong hybrid. At the same time, he's probably going to be one of the highest rated right mids in the British Premier League. So we'll start off with Bale, guys, and as you can see, his stats just all up in the 90s and 80s, except for his defending and headering, but we don't really need him for that. He's got that powerful left foot, which will knock the ball into the back of the net. As you see now, his pace has only increased by a slight bit to 96, but what can you ask for when he's just absolutely so deadly? And then his shooting has gone up to 93, and compared to his normal card, that's an increase in 14, which is one of the biggest increases I've seen so far. But you guys will see one of the bigger increases along the way. I think it's on the reserves that we have the biggest increase in one player. And all of his other stats, guys, 93, 89, very nice stats over there indeed. So he's going to be quite a deadly player. If someone puts him alongside Walcott in a British Premier League team, wow, they're going to get the other team's going to get either paced, abused, or just going to get destroyed by those power shots. He does have a very good long shot as well, and especially I think it's Van Persie has a deadly long shot. So let's move into Mata over here, guys. As you can see, 89 pace, which is an increase in 6. Shooting is now 87, which is a nice increase in 10, so that's a very nice stat for him. And his passing is 88, and dribbling 92. Passing stats, guys, I've noticed a lot of these Spanish players have really good passing, so it's not going to be surprising to see a majority of them trying to hit that around the 90 barrier. So, but yeah, his defending stats still around 50, and headering's around 70, so not very big increases over there. I think it's around 5 or 7 for those stats over there. We'll move into Carrick over here, guys, and kind of an interesting one here. As you can see, his pace has gone up to 70, which is a nice increase in 9, so he's going to be one of the quicker, I think I'd say fairly quick, not say the quickest, but centre mids for an English team. His shooting is now 78, which is fairly good. It's an increase in 7, and his passing's gone all the way up to 90, which is kind of crazy, as that's an increase as well in 7. So majority of his stats have actually increased by around 7, except for, I think, it's his defending, which is, you know, a great stat, because he's a centre defensive mid, going to be able to hold up those attackers, and that is at 86, so that's an increase in 9. So fairly big increase over there, but none of his stats have had that double figure increase just yet. We have Hazard over there now in our right mid position, and he's only had a increase in pace by 3. His shooting's gone to 87, which is a nice increase in 9. Passing around 89, and dribbling's around 95, which is really, really strong, especially for a player over there. He's got 4-star skills, I think, and that's one thing you'd like to have, especially a player with good skills as well as being able to dribble the ball effectively. Going into the defense, guys, I was kind of not too sure why they had Zabaleta over here. I never probably saw him that much this season, but yeah, questionable move, I don't know. We're going to start with Leighton Baines over there, and he's had a nice increase in his pace to 85, which is a nice increase in 6. His shooting is around 79, I think that's an increase in 8. And also his defending, guys, over there, the main important stat for a defender is 86. So the two pace, that the pace and the defending stat are very useful in centre backs and all the defenders in all it together. And those two stats both around even, so they're going to be very effective using him together. And his passing, I think, is also 87. So very nice stats over there. For Tongan, just looking at him just straight away, you'd see his defending and headering stat, and at the same time, he's quite a tall guy, so I'm going to be able to use him a lot, especially from corners on those counter attacks, possibly going straight down the field. I think his shooting's gone up by 11, and then his defending's gone up by 10, so big stat increases over there. He's going to be very useful. Possibly, if you guys have him with company in a Belgium team, he's going to be very strong. So, before he used to be the weak link and people used to use Marlon over him, but now his Team of the Season card looks to be quite deadly. I think most of these cards, guys, have gone down to around 300k, 370k, I think, last time I saw a couple of them. So, keep an eye out. Let me know how their prices are fluctuating. They normally do go down when they firstly come out in packs. They're going to be at the highest, then they go down a bit, and then I think when they go out of packs, their value might creep up a little bit. I'm not too sure. Haven't really looked at the last team of the season just yet. So yeah, we got Rio Ferdinand over here. I think he ended his international career yesterday. So big move over there. His defending stats gone to 91, which is a very strong increase in 7, and also his shooting and his pace have increased both equally by 10, so nice increases over there. And then I think also his passing, that looks a bit different. Yeah, that's an increase in 12. So big man at the back as well, and very useful. You can make quite a nice British Premier League team, well, mainly an English team, but just a couple of these informs. And then finally we move on to our right back over there, Zabaleta. None of his stats have increased crazily or double figures like Carrick over there. Mainly all of them have only increased by 7. I think it's a majority. I've noticed this trend in all the Team of the Seasons over here. If they've not increased by 5 or 6, it's always definitely 7. All of them have a hardcore 7 increase in stat. So as you can see, defending 88 and headering 83. So fairly good over there. Going to be interesting. I have used his normal card, not found it very good. But yeah, it'll be one of those moves that I have to see. And finally, we're going to check on check. We're going to see he's got 90 diving, 87 handling, 91 reflexes, 90 positioning. Going to make him almost deadly, but I still rate Neuer over him. So sadly, would not say he's one of the best keepers. But most of his stats have only increased by 6 and 5. So not major drastic, but if they did improve him even more, then he would be very, very deadly. Probably wouldn't be able to let a ball get past him in the back of the net. We're going to now move on to the subs. So we have Begovic over here. Begovic and Stoke goalkeeper. As you can see, all his stats look very nice. 87 dry diving, 87 reflexes, and then all of his other stats around the 80s except for his speed. So that's going to make him very, very useful. His normal card is fairly good. So if you guys haven't tried it, have a go and just see how it plays out. We're going to move now to, who is it? Williams. And I'm not too sure on this guy. I know his definitely his headering has gone up to 87, but besides that, I think he looks like an alright card. He's got 74 pace for a Welsh centre-back, so kind of can be very useful for those national teams. We got Steven Gerrard over here, guys. A lot of you guys would definitely want to try him out. I want to try him out for his free kicks and his long shots. I've been told they're very, very deadly and effective. And as you can see, 91 shooting, 93 passing. Had some nice increases over there by 5 and 7, so definitely want to try him out. He's one of those players that just look like he's going to be very deadly on the pitch. We've got Santi Cazorla over here, and as you can see from Santi, guys, he's got 88 shooting, 92 passing, 92 dribbling. He's got fairly good stats. I think the main stat he's increased is definitely his shooting by 10, which has gone up to 88. We got Marouane Fellaini, and Fellaini, guys, what can I say? His shooting's gone up by 15. It's kind of crazy. And then at the same time, I believe his defending and headering stats are also very, very good for a midfielder. He's going to be very useful to push back. Probably put him into a centre defensive mid instead of keeping as default cam. And then finally, we got Michu and Benteke. Michu, I've he's had a lot of informs. That's probably the main reason he's got an inform now. And Benteke, guys, as you can see, a lot of stats really powerful in him. Definitely one of the standout stats from this whole team of the season at the minute is definitely his shooting, which has gone all the way up by 21. And that has definitely gone to 86. So going to be quite deadly up front, powerful shots. I've been told he's also got around a very high stat in his power shots and his finishing. So going to be quite interesting to see how he fares. He's also got 88 headering, making him similar, I'd say, one of the similar players to, I'd say, Suarez up front. He got fairly good stats, so going to be quite useful to try him out. And at the same time, his pace is also very good. So, yeah, guys, I think we're going to end up here. I think we're pushing past 10 minutes already, so quite a long review on this team of the season. But if you guys have enjoyed this little review, please do leave a like and subscribe if you are new. Check out my journey series, check out my trading series. Oh yeah, that'll be out tomorrow, guys, the trading series. So yeah, I'll end it up here, guys. So this has been AVJV Gaming, and I'll catch you guys for next episode.